Why should I listen to a person like you who is less successful than me? That night in 2011, I got mad and I started writing all my goals. But every time when I challenged myself, I became a winner. If you don't have goals, you will settle for less. People say, I want to be very rich. Very rich means what?
नए लोग, नई कहानियां और नई सीख. जो स्टॉक्स एंड्रॉइड ऐप पर डाउनलोड करें अभी.
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय नेम इज भूपेंद्र सिंह राठौर एंड आई एम फ्रॉम राजस्थान, अ वेरी स्मॉल विलेज कॉल्ड खातोली. माय एंटायर एजुकेशन हैज बीन फ्रॉम हिंदी मीडियम्स एंड आई हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू स्पीक वेल. आई वॉज वेरी शाय, आई हैड नो कॉन्फिडेंस एंड I was not able to really face the people. But today I'm here. And here I would like to tell you what brought me here. Because that is one thing which can change everyone. And everyone means everyone. I belong to a very small family, very humble family. My father, when I was born, he was a farmer. Then he started working with hotels. And he was able to only afford our education. Well, after that, I joined computer courses because he took 75,000 rupees loan and got me an admission into computer classes. Because at that moment he thought computers is booming and it can really be a future. And it was my future. I really slogged myself. I started learning computers day in and day out and I dedicated my whole life. But I did not know that destiny has different plans for me. I went to Pune, and when I went to Pune, I started utilizing my Saturday and Sunday to learn something beautiful called public speaking. And I started learning public speaking. That gave me a lot of confidence. That gave me a power to face the people like you. Well, 2011, I was standing in front of an audience of around 50 people. And I was talking about success because in 2010, I left my job and chose to be a motivational speaker. When I was addressing those people, a gentleman raised his hand and he said, Bhupendra, I want to ask you something. I said, yes. He said, how successful are you? You are talking about success. How successful are you? I said, what do you mean? He said, which car do you drive? I said, I have Maruti Ritz. He said, do you have your own flat? I said, no, I don't have my own flat. He said, what is your age? I said, 28 years. And after this gentleman said, then why should I learn from you? I am 27 year old and my story is also exactly like your story. Today I have two cars, one Honda City and one Skoda Rapid. And I have two flats of my own, one 1800 square feet and one 700 square feet. And that too in Pune. And I also come from Rajasthan. Why should I listen to a person like you who is less successful than me? Anyways, it was a live 50 people audience. Somehow I could handle that situation. But when I went home in the night, I was only thinking about this one point. I am a motivational speaker. I am coaching people to become successful. And I am not successful. And I realized it that night that yes, some people would not just be motivated by my talks, some people would be motivated by my actions. Actions speak louder than the words. And that night I did not know what to do. So I got an idea. I was going through a lot of motivational speakers that time. I was attending a lot of talks. And one of the talks, they told me about the power of goal settings. I knew about it and I was also teaching people about it, but I did not have goals in writing. That night in 2011, I got mad and I started writing all my goals. I wrote my first goal that in 2013, I want to go to IIMs or ISBs. I want to do one course or MBA from IIM. That was my first goal. I wrote it that night. Why this goal? Because I remember once my father saying I could not afford good education for my kids and I wanted to go to the highest level of education, or I wanted to go to the highest level of institutes. So I wrote my first goal. My second goal, in 2014, 12th January, which is my birthday, I wanted to gift myself a Skoda Rapid, a car, a long car. My third goal, 12th January 2015, which is again my birthday, I wanted to buy my first flat. 12 January 2016, I wanted to launch my book. 12th January 2017, I declared, I wrote my goal, and that was, I want to buy a Mercedes-Benz E-Class, a brand new car. 12th January 2018, I wanted to gift my father a resort or a hotel because he has worked all throughout his life only in hotels and resorts. 12th January 2019, I wanted to be a motivational speaker at the international level. I wanted to deliver my talks internationally. 12th January 2020, I want to enroll for mountaineering expeditions. And 12th January 2021, I'll be enrolling for Everest expedition. I want to climb Mount Everest. 12th January 2030, I wanted to inspire 1 crore people. All these goals I wrote in 2011, that was the first step which I took. The second step which I took was, I went in front of the live audience from my next talk and I started declaring, guys, my goals are this. I was teaching them about goal settings and I started telling them honestly and loudly and clearly that my first goal is this, second goal is this, third goal is this, fourth goal is this. And when I used to tell it to people, some of them never used to believe. Some of them really got inspired that this teacher is teaching us about goal setting and he has his own goals. But you know, guys, what changed after writing those goals and after speaking about those goals in front of public, that I became very, very sincere, not serious, because serious people are in the hospital. We need to be sincere. I became extremely sincere towards my goals. And guess what? 12 January 2013, I enrolled for IIM Lucknow 1-year executive MBA program. 12 January 2014, I got my Skoda Rapid. 12 January 2015, I booked a very nice flat in the best society in Pune called Lodha Belmondo. 12 January 2016, my book, Master Your Thoughts, Master Your Life, was out. 12 January 2017, and the star comes home, the Mercedes-Benz E-Class. 12 January 2018, I opened a resort, Pushkar Pride Camp and Resorts at Pushkar, because my father had always worked in hotels for somebody else. I wanted him to own a resort. 12 January 2019, my goal was to speak at international platforms. This goal was accomplished in 2017 itself. I went to Singapore, I went to Dubai, and spoke in many international repute conferences over there and address thousands of people over there. Now, my dear friends, every year I address around 25,000 to 50,000 people, and my goal is to inspire 1 crore people before 2030, and my next goal is to inspire 10 crore people by 2040. Guess what, my dear friends? Today, when I look back and I think about myself, when I was in 2011, I used to earn only 25,000 rupees. And when I was looking at my current situation, achieving these kind of dreams were almost impossible. When I was going on the stage and talking to people about them, everybody said, unbelievable. Many said, Bhupendra, you would not be able to do it. Many people came and asked me, sir, the date is coming. Would you be able to buy your Mercedes-Benz? And to be very honest, every time it was tough. Every time it was challenging. I challenged myself. I declared this openly. But every time when I challenged myself, I became a winner. So what I have learned in this journey is very simple. If you don't have goals, you will settle for less. If you have goals, you will achieve almost everything in your life. You live only once, my friends. You live only once, and it's your responsibility to live with dignity, live with passion, live as an inspired being. Challenge yourself, inspire yourself on a daily basis. I want to give you a small tip on how to set the goals. You may have heard that goals should be SMART. S stands for specific, means you must know what is your goal. It should be visible. You should be able to understand. For example, if you want to buy a car, which brand, which car, which make, should it be brand new, should it be secondhand, specific, measurable. People say, I want to be very rich. Very rich means what? I want to be peaceful means what? you need to have measurable goals. A, achievable. All your goals should be achievable. R, your goals should be realistic. And T, your goals should have a time and a date. This almost everybody has heard, but I want to tell you a few more things here. The first S is specific, but I want to give you another S, which is stretch. The goal should be such which can stretch you beyond your limits. It should be able to stretch you. It is not a goal if it is not stretching you. For example, if you have 10 lakh rupees in your bank and you say, I will buy a car in 3 months, this is not a goal, this is a decision. If you have 5 lakh rupees and you can arrange 5 lakh rupees tomorrow and you say, I will buy a car in 3 months, again, it is a decision. It is not a goal. Goal is the goal only when it is stretched. Number two, the goal is a goal when you really share this goal with the people. When you share it with people, automatically you feel accountable and then you work towards that goal with more passion. When it comes to M, it is measurable, but I want to give you two more M's. One, that it should be mindful. Means you should be aware that during this goal setting process and achievement process, you may fail. Situations may change, government policies may change, GST might come or the demonetization might happen. But still, since it is your goal, who is responsible? You are responsible. While setting the goal, ensure the worst can happen and the best can happen. Prepare your mind for both. That is called mindfulness. And the third M is meaningful. Each and every goal of yours should be meaningful. Means you should have a strong reason for achieving that goal. Like I achieved the resort goal only because there was a strong meaning. And apart from that, two more. Goal should not be just smart, it should be smarter. The next E in the sequence of smarter is for enjoyable. You must enjoy the goals. You must feel alive while you're working towards those goals. You must become more passionate while achieving those goals. And R, when you achieve that goal, it should give you huge rewards. Not only just that resort, but fulfillment, happiness, prestige, you know, name or fame or anything else. If you have all those things, I'm sure your goals will be great. So today itself, I want you to set your goals. Your goal should be smarter and make sure that each and every goal, you put a lot of energy. You live only once. You have all the rights to become rich. You have all the reasons to become perfect. All you need is within you now. You just need to realize it. Thank you so much. Wish you all a great life. Thank you.
Tell us what you think about this video and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.